Honduras is where it all began. I can't get the image out of my head where we were passing brick to brick to brick, and it was that moment that I really started to understand that we gotta push ourselves harder because we're capable of it. We need to.
Africa was, for me, special.
At the very end, I took a minute just to walk around the place all by myself, and again, just seeing, like, holy crap, we were here just for a little over, 10 days. What our group could do in 10 days was just amazing.
Into our third year, the Titan Alarm and Strike Alarm family have always generously donated their time and money towards a charity project for those less fortunate. For 2012, our charity initiative has brought us to an orphanage in desperate need of assistance down in South America. This is Project Cusco.
Project Cusco is basically helping a home where they're hosting 50 children and is bettering their living conditions, improving just the general living area where these kids are now living.
This orphanage used to be a hospice that was donated. Now, somewhere along the line, it was converted to an orphanage, but it gets very, very little, if any, probably actually no resources from the government. And the idea was to come in and leave the places in a position where it could be independent financially. We chose this project because the place was frankly quite a disaster.
We got a call from Nick, and he heard about an orphanage that was in dire need of getting a facelift. The place was really, really run down, and once Nick gave us that call, I think it got everybody so fired up to come.
So for 15 days in November, over 100 representatives from Titan Alarm Canada and Strike Alarm United States traveled to Cusco, Peru to work on many projects in the orphanage to make its standard of living for the children more bright and positive.
In, you kind of walk in the doors not really knowing what to expect, and we walked in and all the kids were lined up around the main courtyard.
You walk in this entrance and they're just staring at you, expecting some kind of change in their life, you know what I mean? And all of a sudden they rush at you and give you a hug. I think if you had saw the faces of our reps, and even myself and you, our hearts just crumbled. It was amazing.
On our first day, immediately after meeting the children, we brought in our work supplies, and our first gift to them all, new mattresses.
We just arrived with mattresses for the kids. Right now they're sharing beds, and they don't have enough beds for all the people that are staying in the facility.
Building a fort. Building a fort. I don't think for the kids, I think for Ian.
It's unfortunate that the orphanage doesn't have the money to replace them. Every child was more than happy to receive one new mattress and one new pillow.
Those? They're trying to hide them. There they have them.
Okay, some of the things that we're doing in this orphanage were for first thing, which was most important of all, improving the bathrooms in the project.
I did a special tour before everybody walked in. The bathroom was an unanticipated project. We went ahead and started from day one, start tearing everything apart, and for them to have a new facility.
Everything in all four bathrooms was taken down, retiled, and replaced with brand new sinks, showers, and toilets.
So this is the duck farm. If you take a look around, this is where they hang out. All they really have to play in is this grungy water on the side there. So we're planning on building a pond.
The side project raised ducks and guinea pigs. With the repainting of the guinea pig home and the construction of the duck pond, even the animals received an update to their living conditions.
Hey, you got it.
Hey,
we need these
We're breaking concrete here in Costco. Renew in Costco. Renew in the floor. So the kids won't step on the old floor.
That was a lot of work. It spent a full day chipping away a full layer of concrete on it. And then yesterday we spent about 6-7 hours, about 60 of us passing buckets of concrete all the way down.
Moving buckets of cement, building the sidewalk. It's real good. They're not getting any lighter.
They're heavy.
But I'm constantly getting stronger, so.
I don't know where the buckets are coming from. It's a mystery, they just keep coming.
The only heavy part is having to kind of pick up the dead weight on either side.
Role in the project. The playground, classrooms, hallways, and stairwells were redone with brighter colors.
We're just putting the first coat of paint on the walls. We're going to paint all the way around, then the second coat, and then I guess probably some murals and stuff put up afterwards.
Well, I was painting the brown here, and then I'm an idiot and I screwed up and went too far, so now I'm just going to paint the whole door frame with it. I'm not exactly a professional.
Updating the walkway, the courtyard was landscaped to have flowers and trees all around with decorative painted rocks.
We're just carrying in all the flowers we're going to plant in all the gardens around here. Just kind of spruce it up a little bit, make it a little bit more beautiful, a little bit more livable. These kids had a hard time in their life. Just try to make it a little bit more reasonable to live in.
These kids don't have parents. They don't have a home. This is it. And it's pretty humbling to be able to see the circumstances, their living conditions, and really make a difference.
Just we want to have a nice place for the kids to have a smile and just enjoy their day.
It's the little things, the simple things that make everyone happy and make people's lives easier. And that's what Titan's about.
Man, charity work is awesome. Gotta love it. For a good cause, but it's hard as heck.
Titan and Strike Alarm worked with the orphanage. A great deal had been accomplished, from renovating the courtyard, to the updated computer room, to the renovated bathrooms, and to the new volleyball court. The facility has never looked better. It's now in a more sustainable state prior to our arrival. And while the building got the proper love and affection it needed, so did the children.
These kids, they need to be shown a lot of love, really. They need to be given attention. They need to know that people care about them because this is what they are lacking. And the fact that there's this whole team of people that comes in and just changes their whole living conditions does really make a huge difference in their lives.
You know, you can just see, frankly, attention starved some of these kids are. Sometimes they just need a hug or someone to play with them. Though we can't stay around to provide all that, we felt that what we could do is at least put the house back in order just to create a nice home where this can happen and where these kids can grow.
This hard work could never have been completed without the dedication from our Titan and Strike Alarm representatives. We find that as we look back on our lives, the moments that stand out are the moments when we have done things for others. And with that in mind, we should never doubt that a small group of thoughtful people can make a change. Indeed, it is the only thing that ever has.
People are missing something in their lives by not doing charity. So whether it's business or not, I think just human beings. I don't know how else to put it. And I think I even forget how lucky our crew is, our company is, to be able to do this. And I think we need the reminders, fine. But when you get them, they're so profound, and it changes your life every single time. Even in year three, it really, really does.
I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my
Another, I just wanted to paint my orange rock, you know?